Welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering. Today we will discuss traveling wave tubes, wave modes, nature of four propagation constants. In the previous class, we have derived four propagation constants: gamma 1, gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, and gamma 4. These three, gamma 1, gamma 2, and gamma 3, corresponds to three forward traveling waves, and gamma 4 corresponding to backward traveling wave. Today we will discuss, so what is the importance of this gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, and gamma 4, and we will furthermore discuss about these three forward traveling waves and one backward. What is its nature of these three forward traveling waves and nature of this backward traveling wave? So before that, so let us briefly discuss about again the helix traveling wave tube. So this is the helical slow wave structure. The RF input which is to be amplified is given to one end of the slow wave structure. So you can see the RF input which is to be amplified. So at the other end of the helix, the RF output or amplified output is taken at the other end of the helix. See, the RF input traveling through the slow wave structure produces an axial electric field, which explained in the previous lecture. So we have also derived the expression for axial electric field. So the RF input traveling through the slow wave structure produces an axial electric field which will be traveling in positive z direction. Let us say the axis of the helix is a positive z direction. The axial electric field is traveling in positive z direction. So then if the electron enters this helix, there is an interaction between the electron beam and the axial electric field. So this is what we have discussed in this previous lecture. So therefore, now we'll see today what is the importance of this gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, and gamma 4. So first we write it as there are four propagation constants. There are four propagation constants corresponding to four modes of propagation of O-type helix traveling wave tube. So there are four propagation constants. There will be four modes corresponding to each propagation constant. Number 2, so the propagation constants are given as, so which we have derived. So here represent gamma 1. So gamma 1, what is the gamma 1 formula? -√3/2 beta e into c plus j beta e into 1 plus c/2. So this is the first propagation constant corresponding to first forward traveling wave. So for gamma 2, just minus is replaced by plus and the remaining term is as it is. So gamma 2 is equal to √3/2, so beta e into c plus j beta e into 1 plus c/2. Gamma 3, so this gamma 2 is also corresponding to forward traveling wave. So gamma 3 is equal to j beta e into 1 minus, and this also corresponds to forward traveling wave. So gamma 4 is equal to minus j beta e into 1 minus c³/4. So these four propagation constants are very, very important formulas. So while solving the problems, it will be asked to calculate gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, and gamma 4. So you can find these kind of problems on gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, and gamma 4. So now let us take the first one, gamma. So let us take the side heading. So the wave can be written as, as you know from electromagnetics, the wave is written as e⁻¹ into z. In general, the wave traveling in some direction is written like this. So e power minus gamma into z. Substitute here. So e power minus, what is gamma? We have minus root 3 by 2 into beta e into c plus, so j beta e into 1 plus c by 2. So if you multiply this, so separate the exponentials, root 3 by 2 beta e into c into e power minus j beta e into 1 plus c by 2. So you can clearly see that. So this represents, so generally from electromagnetics, this represents wave traveling in positive z direction, since it is minus is there, so therefore it is represents the wave traveling in positive z direction. So this is in e power x format, the wave is exponentially growing. So therefore what we can write about this first one is A, the wave corresponding to gamma 1 is a forward traveling wave, because it is traveling in positive z direction, it is a forward traveling wave. So what is the amplitude? The amplitude increases exponentially. Forward traveling wave whose amplitude increases exponentially with distance. Whose amplitude decreases exponentially with distance. So that means the wave can be written like this. So the amplitude of the wave corresponding to gamma 1 is a forward traveling wave whose amplitude increases exponentially because of multiplication of this term by e power some x format. So because of this, the amplitude of this wave exponential. Let us see the second point about this wave. This wave travels or propagates with a velocity slightly lower than velocity of electron beam. So this point is very, very important. This wave propagates with a velocity that is slightly less than the velocity of electron beam. Due to that, there is a transfer of energy. There is a transfer of energy from electron beam to the wave. So this one is very, very important. This wave propagates with a velocity, so that is slightly lower than the velocity of electron beam. So therefore the electron beam transfers its energy to this wave. So that's why its amplitude grows exponentially with the distance. So this is what you have to write about gamma 1. So gamma 1, it represents a forward traveling wave whose amplitude increases exponentially with the distance. This wave travels slightly lower than the velocity of electron beam. So there is a transfer of energy of electron beam to this wave. So this is the nature of gamma 1. Let us see the nature of gamma 2. Let us represent it as A, capital A. So now let us represent it capital B, gamma 2. Similarly, the wave corresponding to gamma 2 is written as, so e power minus gamma 2 into z. So substitute e power minus, what is gamma? So root 3 by 2, so beta e into c plus, so j beta e into 1 plus c by 2.
If you separate this, you can find e power minus root 3 by 2 into beta e into c into e power minus j beta e into 1 plus c by 2.
So these terms are very, very important. This represents, again, what is, because of minus sign, this represents wave traveling in positive z direction.
So this represents a forward traveling wave. So because of e power minus x format, the amplitude decreases exponentially.
So that is what we can write about this, the points about this.
So A, this wave is a forward traveling wave. This wave is a forward traveling wave. So what is its amplitude? This is a forward traveling wave whose amplitude decreases exponentially with distance. So that is, this is written as, since its amplitude decreases exponentially with the distance.
So because of this format of the wave. So now, again, similar to this wave propagates with a velocity, again this wave propagates with a velocity slightly lower than that of electron beam. Similar to gamma 1, this wave travels with a velocity slightly lower than velocity of electron beam. But here there is a transfer of energy from the wave to electron beam. That's why, since there is a transfer of energy from the wave to the electron beam, this wave starts decreasing exponentially. The difference between gamma 1 and gamma 2. Let us see the C, option C, gamma 3. So the wave corresponding to gamma 3 is written as, so what we can write, e power minus gamma 3 into z, that is what we can write from electromagnetics. So e power minus gamma 3, what is gamma 3? So gamma 3 is, so j beta e into 1 minus c into z. So here you can see that, so there is no amplitude increase or amplitude decrease term, e power x or e power minus x is not there. So therefore, what is this? This wave is also a forward traveling wave. So this is forward traveling wave. So because of minus e power minus j beta x format, this is a forward traveling wave. So therefore, let us write the points about this. So this is a forward traveling wave. This is a forward traveling wave. So because of minus term, e power minus j beta x format from electromagnetics. So this is a forward traveling wave whose amplitude remains constant. So the amplitude remains constant because of e power x, e power minus x terms are not there here. So the amplitude remains constant. But what is the velocity? If this wave travels with a velocity slightly higher than that of the electron beam. So this wave propagates with a velocity slightly higher than that of velocity of electron beam. So for this mode, there is no transfer of energy between the electron beam and the wave.
So there is no transfer of energy between electron beam and the wave. So this point is very, very important. There is no energy transfer between these two, electron beam and the wave.
So this is what about the gamma 3, nature of gamma 3. Let us write the fourth one, last one, D, gamma 4.
See this, the wave corresponding to gamma 4 is given as,
the wave corresponding to gamma 4 is given as what we can write from electromagnetics,
e power minus gamma 4 into z, substitute e power gamma 4, so that is minus into minus will become plus, so j beta e into 1 minus c cube by 4. So since this is in the format of e power j beta x format, so what it represents? The wave traveling in or beta z format, this represents the wave traveling in negative z direction. So therefore this wave is a backward traveling wave that is traveling in negative z direction. Because of this format, the wave is traveling in, it is a backward traveling wave, that is traveling in negative z direction. Again, this wave travels with a velocity slightly higher than that of the velocity of electron beam. Similarly, this wave propagates with a velocity slightly higher than velocity of electron beam.
So this wave also will not contribute to any energy transfer between there is no energy transfer between electron beam and the wave.
So but this wave can be removed by using attenuators at the center of traveling wave tube which we have shown in the diagram.
So there is a attenuator placed at the center of the traveling wave. By using this wave can be, the reflected wave or backward traveling wave can be removed. So this is the nature of gamma 4. So this is all about the nature of four propagation constants. The wave corresponding to gamma 1 is a forward traveling wave. So this wave grows exponentially with this distance. This wave propagates with a velocity slightly lower than that of the electron beam. So there is a transfer of energy from electron beam to this wave. Similarly, gamma 2. So this also represents a forward traveling wave whose amplitude decreases exponentially. This wave also propagates at a velocity slightly lower than that of the electron beam. But there is a transfer of energy from the wave to the electron beam. Similarly, gamma 3, this represents also a forward traveling wave, but its amplitude remains constant, but it travels at a velocity slightly higher than the velocity of electron beam. No energy transfer takes place between the electron beam and the wave. So finally, gamma 4, this represents a backward traveling wave. This wave also travels with a velocity slightly higher than that of the electron beam. So this wave can be removed with the help of attenuator placed at the center of the helical tube, which we have seen in the diagram of traveling wave tube. So this is what you have to write in the examination about this nature of four propagation constants to get full marks. Thank you.